Expressions are reusable, common building blocks that incorporate custom business logic into enterprise data management tasks and processes. With expressions, you can calculate data values, evaluate data conditions, specify criteria, and build filters that are unique to your organization's requirements. For example, you can use expressions to transform property values when you share data across applications, derive the value for a property based on the value of another property, and create custom validations for node types or hierarchy sets. You can also use expressions to define a node condition in various filters. For example, expressions in policy filters define which nodes trigger data governance workflows when you make changes to them. Expressions in subscription filters define nodes that you want to subscribe to in a source viewpoint. And expressions in extract filters define which nodes are included in the extract. Expressions are made up of statements containing expression terms made up of objects and operators, which can further be refined by selecting attributes, collections, and methods. You design expressions graphically in the Expression Builder, a visual interface that requires minimal coding or scripting knowledge. The Expression Builder has two areas: the palette, which contains statements, objects, and operators that you use in the expression, and the editor, where you compose the expression. The toolbar enables you to copy and paste expression terms, copy a text version of the expression to your clipboard, load and save the expression from and to a JSON file, test the expression, and undo and redo actions. Let's create an expression to derive a value for the data storage property. For bottom nodes that do not have a formula, the value should be store. For parent nodes and bottom nodes with a formula, the value should be dynamic calc. You create an expression by selecting either an if or a return statement. You can insert a statement anywhere there is a blue arrow in the editor. When you add a statement to the editor, a vertical blue bar indicates a statement block. You can nest statements within other statements, and each statement is indicated by a blue bar. To remove a statement block, click its blue bar and then select Remove. As you select expression terms for statements, terms and statement blocks are outlined in red to indicate that they are not valid. If you hover over the outlined term, you can view an error message. In this example, the if statement must evaluate to a Boolean value. The message for the invalid statement block indicates that it needs a return statement. In this case, the if statement needs both an else statement and the return statement, which I can insert by dragging them from the palette. Next, you select objects and operators for your expression. In the expression term for the statement, use the palette or click the Choose Expression Term icon to select an object or an operator. To check that the node is a bottom node without a formula, I'll select the AND operator to link two expression terms. For the first expression term, I'll select a node object. Next, I'll select attributes for the node object. To evaluate if the node is a bottom node, select the Core Stats Bottom Node property. Notice that the first expression term is no longer outlined in red. For the second expression term, I'll select the formula property. Because the formula property is a string, I'll check if the property contains either a null value or an empty string by applying the isEmpty method. Finally, I'll define return values for the derived property. To make the expression easier to understand and maintain, you can also add a comment statement. It's a good practice to test your expression before saving it to ensure that the expression logic works as expected. When I test a bottom node without a formula, the expression returns store. For a bottom node with a formula, the expression returns dynamic calc. When I test a parent node, the expression returns dynamic calc. After testing the expression, click Apply to return to the property inspector. You can access the expression builder anywhere you see the Edit Expression icon. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.